We're looking at my design for an artificial womb. It consists of 5 big balloons where babies would be in, kind of swimming in their own fluids. There's different circulations with the tubes, circulation of fluids, of blood.
When I was a gynecologist in training about 27 years ago, I knew it was possible to do this. And the main difference is that an artificial womb is filled with liquid, and the incubator is filled with air. An incubator is a kind of hostile environment for extremely preterm babies. Air damages the lungs.
Yeah.
So the baby is born now, very preterm baby, very small, and then we're putting the baby in the artificial womb, and then we are going to connect the baby immediately to an artificial placenta. The artificial womb is a liquid environment filled with water and all kinds of minerals. So the baby gets the oxygen and the nutrients via the umbilical cord, just like when they are in a natural environment. There we keep the baby for several weeks. The baby grows, and after 4 weeks we do the birth again. That could save a lot of lives.
I imagine further down in the future, an artificial womb could become part of a lifestyle choice for women, because you don't have to worry about the morning sickness, changes into your body. I think it could be very interesting for some people, like if you think about gay men. I feel like there's this narrative in society that there is this ideal of natural reproduction. Natural reproduction is not the only way.
I don't think this will be a solution for women who are not able to get kids. We don't know what consequences are for the babies. We do nothing to know about the short-term and the long-term implications. This project will take about 5 years, and then we're going to start with human babies.